Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Saint Mordecai back here. It has been a while. I've been working my tail off, because that's what adulting is. I am so excited to finally play Life is Strange Before the Storm. I didn't know it was going to come that quickly to the end of August. It is now freaking September 1st. Oh my goodness, we only have 4 more months until the new year. Jeez, 2018 is right around the corner. I can't believe it. Now, if you guys have not, I repeat, if you have not seen my Life is Strange Let's Play of all the previous episodes of season one? I mean, this is a different game, so this really isn't season two, because this is technically a prequel of Life is Strange. But if you haven't seen my Life is Strange Let's Play of all the previous 5 episodes, check that out when you get a chance. I'll try to leave a link in the description if I remember, because I'm getting old and I'm very forgetful these days. So, Life is Strange takes place before the events. Well, Life is Strange Before the Storm, which makes sense, perfect name. The events of this take place before Life is Strange, when there was actually a storm in Life is Strange. So that, it explains itself. Anyway, I'm excited. We get to play as Chloe. Super excited. Super excited to do that. Why does it say I'm disconnected from the network? I'm not. I'm streaming live. They're lying to me. They're lying. How rude. And I'm gonna do a test. I'm gonna see. I'm gonna make sure that I am connected to the interwebs. If you see something pop up in the right, upper right corner, it'll mean that I am still connected to the interwebs. And there it is, Bob. I am. Okay. Good. That's all I wanted to know. So I am ready to play this, and it might take about 2 hours, but that's okay. I don't care. I'm prepared. Let's do this. Start episode 1. Nice. These we cannot start yet. Can't start these anytime soon. Can't happen. So, episode 1, Awake, where we're gonna be playing as Chloe and learning about Rachel Amber. Let's do it! Oh, I'm so excited. Oh my goodness. Ooh, I love games like this. Hopefully the music is just as good as in the original Life is Strange. That would be nice. Because the soundtrack for Life is Strange was really, really freaking good. Life is Strange Before the Storm is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. Man, I love games like this. Smoking is not a good thing to do. Your lungs will not be happy about it. Save money. Buy it on CDs or something better. First off, that train says 1337, which means elite in elite speak, meaning it's elite. But you know, you might want to get off the tracks. Just a thought. Why are you so calm about it? That is nothing to be so calm about, Chloe. Jeez, you are always trying to kill yourself from way back when. God!
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes!
I'm happy subtitles are originally on.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
So excited. I'm gonna look at like almost every little thing, so if this gameplay takes 3 hours, you'll be fine. She looks fantastic. She looks like a teen with angst and just pissed. This is before Chloe dyed her hair freaking blue. But, what was I saying? Yes, I'm happy subtitles are already on, because I was like, crap, I forgot to turn the subtitles on. But they're already on. Fence. Gotta get used to the walking. Let's look at the fence.
No trespassing? No way.
Hell yeah. Well done. Tap! Flicking off fences. Alright. Badass Chloe.
Holy shit.
That looks like quite the rager,
this
Chloe.
This place is awesome.
I wasn't into stuff like that.
I'll have to get through that door.
I totally wasn't into stuff like that when I was a kid. I'll move faster. Okay. I don't want to run in on the place. What's this? Yeah, look at it.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
Foreshadowing! Not gonna say much more than that, but, again, gotta tune into Life is Strange for, those little tidbits of foreshadowing. Damn.
Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
Sorry about it.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again, I swear. You can trust me, I promise. I really get it now, I do.
Do you? Because trust with me is earned in actions, not words.
I agree with you on that. I'd rather actions than words. Actions always speak louder than words. People don't realize that.
Some say the world will end in fire. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show.
An hour?
This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
Yeah, I'm still getting over my cold, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry for the, gross noise.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Yeah, I mean, that's awfully close to the fire. They're just asking for it. Ooh, I'm so... Hold on.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
I so want one of these real quick. Can I just have one? I want one. I feel like the sensitivity on this game is a little high. Just a little, and I don't think I could change it. Let's see. Yeah, that sensitivity is just a little high. Can we just move that down just a bit? Let's do that. Okay, good. Thank you. All right, that's a little better. Gosh.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends.
All right, now I feel better.
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
New dialogue unlocked. Hello! How are you?
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
What does that say behind it? Blood, sport, taste, iron, punk. That doesn't sound safe. Hey man, sup?
Help you, miss?
Oh, he's sweet.
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Damn. All right, bet.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Let me talk to him one more time. Can we talk about your bike, please?
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
He's so badass.
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
It isn't?
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Alright. Fine. Screaming won't help.
Yeah, keep walking.
Oh, don't piss Chloe off, bliss. I would do it, but I'm like, it's too soon. It's too soon to start ruffling feathers. Don't have time for that.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Can I go around the other side of that RV by any chance? I don't think I can. No, wait, can I? Can I? Can I? No, I cannot. Okay. Let's try and see if we can get through this back door that's back here. Da-da. Excuse me. Look at these bikes, though. They're so badass. I would get... That red one's pretty nice, even though red is not my color. But I'd probably still take this one right here. But not that front wheel. I don't want such a high-profile rim.
A second door inside? So close, and yet so far.
Looks like it could be open from the outside, Chloe.
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Oh dear. I think yelling will not help, but I think they want me to do it. I don't see any alternatives here. Can I paint this? Can I paint it? Do it.
Perfect place for me to work.
Don't want it.
Now what to draw?
A bunny. Okay, I'm not gonna try and lure children in there. So, because free candy, that's a bad idea.
Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
Yeah, that's better. Do that one.
I'm sorry, officer. It says what on the side of my RV?
Terrible. Oh, man. I forgot about journal life. Oh, I forgot this exists. Oh, boy. Okay. So this is back in, what? April 4th of, I guess, 2010. And she's writing to Max here. Boy. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's start from the beginning of March 5th, 2010. Dear Max, Dad got me this stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down. And tonight I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. Funny thing is, I don't really know what to say because we haven't talked in 3 months, despite all my calls and texts and not that I'm upset or anything. F, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the Unfriended. Damn. Page 1 of 3. Now, this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten all about me, we kiss and make up. I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Oh, the foreshadowing. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max and you'll just live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. That's a lot of adjectives. Chloe the Journal Boss. That drawing, though, makes me laugh. Put your thoughts in me. That's kind of funny. Okay, March 20th, 2010. Ready! So Mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David. The wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. David, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That effing David. Anyway, I politely suggested to Mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then. Or breathing. Well, damn, Chloe, that escalated quickly. Hey, ish happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. Excuse me. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues, and I've got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. She can do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like I'm the... Chloe the... Max, so you know how I stopped going to class so much, like you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being the dead dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figured this out sooner. Think of all this wasted school time. P.S. Pris from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. Oh dear. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and that smolder of his, but then Pris just totally sold the show. Probably nothing there. Just think I just want her bangs. Chloe, the electric sheep. Interesting, interesting. What else is in this journal? Ah, backstory. Lovely. Boy. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me, I guess, that thing. I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently sending a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which I get it, I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter or student, or anything really. But who the F wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection and it sucks booty. Other than that, other things that suck. Mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend, David. How hard it is to buy weed around here, having no friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say, chillax, dad being dead. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash, and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times I remember that he's feeding worms in a ditch right now, and anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. At least I have two weapons to help me survive. Town, the pen I use to tag any and everything I want, and my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. Despite my mom's efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know Isha's been rough since Dad died, money's tight, her job as a waitress at a diner isn't exactly glamorous, and I'm clearly not at all about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on the both of us? She acts like if I smoke pot or when I skip out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She should be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. She never used to be this way when Dad was around. She could actually be cool. But lately there's a hairy if, monster. Nice drawing, by the way. She let into the house that's effing everything up. David Madsen, a jobless brainless. How does she know he has no... little ish with a hard... Anyway. For the military and promised to whip me into shape. Anus. I've tried to express these concerns to my mom, yet every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry that the David flu is the kind of disease that kills its host. Excuse my yawn. Mercy. Max Caulfield, MIA ex-best friend extraordinaire. This artsy mother effer loves photography more than life itself and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past, but who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up like pirates and eat ice cream and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and save people in ish. Then my dad died, and her dad got some job up north and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her most, and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my texts so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore, and that she probably has all new friends up in effing Seattle, I still miss her. If she came back tomorrow and said, "Hey Chloe, wanna dress up like pirates and be stupid together?" I would take her back in a heartbeat. Loved up in a heartbeat. If I had a nickel bag for every jerk-off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write ish about Dad over the last couple of years, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again. What's the matter? Don't you want to write about dear old Dad? I guess they think it helps me cope with my feelings or whatever, as if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are still plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. And what the F am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad, who was always fun to be around and never angry, that he treated me like an equal, that he was constantly working to make our lives better, that he could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch, that he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy, and that his barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again are both so painful that it's easier for Mom and me just to pretend neither of us notices it. If that's coping, then coping can go F itself. Oh, William, sad face. Alright, so there's the backstory. For those of you who don't know, Chloe, father's dead, best friend's moved, and, she's coping. Alright, so these two can't do anything there. I'm gonna explore a little bit before I go postal on this guy. I don't think I can. What is this?
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
It's probably gonna stop me from going any further soon. Yep, I'm closed in. Alright, I have to go yell at him. Great. Unless I can... is that a thing I can fit through? No, that's just graffiti. Wait, let me double check. Oh yeah, that's just graffiti. I thought that was a hole for a second. Okay. I gotta yell at him. Ah, great. Don't wanna. It's making me do it. Don't do it.
Got it. Again? What do you want, kid?
And he's so sweet, too. But I have to make a scene. A backtalk challenge. This doesn't sound safe.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In backtalk, you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want. Why do I have to insult him, really? Aw, damn it.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Okay, you started it. Let's do it. Bedtime. Rude. Your bedtime. No bedtime.
I don't sleep. It's for the weak.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Again, listen to your opponent's words. Fine.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Sometimes the right choices are a bit more difficult to pick around. Here, playground is a good response to kid. Okay.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
Girl like you, I can't protect you in there.
Protection? She don't need no damn protection.
A girl like you with pretty flowers on her bicycle shouldn't lecture me on what
damn.
I do.
That is a traditional Samoan. Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
Jesus, Chloe.
You're all right, kid. Go on in.
Damn. She's so badass. So I guess the meter shows, like, if the bouncer's getting closer to the center, or whoever's on the opposite side is getting closer to the middle, and the goal is the middle. Okay, so Chloe's just, like, landslided that one, because I had a tutorial. But good to know. That's pretty cool. Interesting new, interesting mechanic.
This is intense! Shit!
Ophelia, come!
You dog.
Dude, that's cool. Question everything. Is she like the only girl in here?
Just follow the lights and the sound.
Excuse
Can't
me.
Wait to get in there and thrash. That dog is fierce.
I'm not gonna try and pet you though. F that. Oh, she's done
Sober
for.
Up, girl. You're missing the show.
Okay, good. That's exactly what we need. Thank you.
That shirt is rad.
No.
Is that guy selling merch?
This up exactly as I'm explaining to you.
Wish I had some cash.
All right, it's not going to take any more than an hour to do it.
Hey, are you selling
20
any...
$20.
What?
$20 for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick.
I highly doubt I can steal this shirt while he's...
Exactly as I'm explaining to you. All right?
You can't take it while he's right there.
I told you $20. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
I was like, I highly doubt I'd be able to... Yeah. Let's attempt to pet the dog. Get our lives left up.
What's her name?
Delia.
Aww, cute.
She doesn't usually like people.
Alright, just people, mate.
Yeah.
I'm Chloe Price.
Me neither.
What is this? Oh, I can tag it.
Daemon Merrick again?
Excuse me.
Who is this guy?
Oh, I can't tag it. What's this?
Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down any minute.
I think we should do it.
Releasing that brake would roll the car right out from under that tool. Do I want a firewalk shirt that bad? I think I do.
What would Chloe do? Yep, she'd do it. La 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 la.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Do 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 do.
Shit! No 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 no! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick.
Damn. Yoink. Thank
oh,
you.
Yeah. Sweet, sweet victory. That's like $200.
What would Chloe do? Yup. This is not the stuff I do in real life. This
Holy
is all
shit.
What Chloe would do.
I'm rich.
It's not gonna end well.
Nothing sadder than a neglected bomb.
Okay. Let's start scooting out of this area real quick, cause try not to get caught.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday. Sketch Central.
She is quite chill. Hey, chill girl, how you doing?
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room? Reminds me of the way I make important life choices.
Bad way to make choices.
Cold beer, free for the taking.
All the stuff not to do. Don't drink too much, Chloe. You're a lightweight.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please. Graffiti everywhere. I think they missed a spot. What are you looking at?
That's pretty cool.
Much better.
Nice.
Damn, there are a lot of people here. Here we go.
Oh, damn it.
Fuck.
Hey. Sorry.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
I can't talk to him? Okay.
Hey.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha! The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Where do those stairs go?
Up. Excuse me.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean,
Will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Don't need it.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Don't need it. I already had her do enough stuff.
Looks dicey.
It's like I already had her drink. I'm not gonna have her friggin' smoke too. It's too much. It's just too much. How are there still beer bottles upstairs?
Fuck, yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
Nice. All music is copyrighted by Square Enix and Don't Nod and all those other people. So... she looks like she's having the time of her life.
You spilled my beer, bitch!
Oh, boy.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough. We're not done.
You want to be insulted? Okay, fine.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Oh boy.
Hey, dickhead.
I'm just gonna run. Not gonna attack him.
Rachel? Come on. Hurry up.
I was like, I'm not gonna attack him. I'm just gonna leave.
Let me go, Frank.
Not gonna happen. Calm down.
Come on, man.
Thanks, Frank.
Screw this.
Get the fuck out of here.
Well, she's lucky that Rachel was there, damn it. Because without Rachel, that could have ended pretty badly. Chloe always has someone saving her butt. I swear, every single altercation, she always has someone saving her. Every time. Thank you. like that hand statue, and it's covered all in the covered all in the pride flag color. It's kind of cute. That's how I feel every time I see a cigarette. That. I wish choking and coughing over here. Twice. Alright, let's start this. Oh, boy. Episode 1, Awake.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
Life is just safer that way sometimes, kiddo.
Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Alright, May 7, 2010. Max, the loser. Yes, that's right. I called you a loser. Want to know why? Because you weren't at Firewalk last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer. Or Mom, if you're reading this, he's my dealer and you shouldn't be reading this. Nice. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked to this old mill using the train tracks, then verbally abused this dumb bouncer until he let me inside. Firewalk was the ish. Who knew ragers like that went down in Arcadia Bay, F Seattle? I almost got my butt kicked. NBD... But there were these two anus skeevy guys whose manhood I wrecked. Oh yeah, and I got rescued by the most popular girl at school. How was your night, loser? Firewalk plus Chloe is greater than Max. Damn, tell us how you really feel, Clo-Clo. Mercy. This place is awesome. Poor Clo-Clo, she's like, I don't want to do anything.
Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Chloe, wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. One of these days, I'm actually going to use you to do my homework. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
Intriguing. Dear Miss Arcadia, did you hear about Firewalk coming to town? I checked all the local venues, but nobody knows anything.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year. Had a near-death experience eating this.
That's why that place is shutting down. That'll do it. Not all the local venues, apparently. Don't know, but bumping the thread. Okay, gents, here's a scoop. It's a private priority, not as in you're not invited. More like you're better off staying away, and I know that just made one some of you more into it than ever, so proceed at your own risk and abandon all hope all you enter. Ever heard of the mill? And they're like, oh, ish, if you go, don't look anybody in the eyes. If you look anybody in the eyes, don't look away. If you look away, why would you start listening to my advice now? Haha, look at my eyes. My eyes are alien. Great movie. What are you talking about? Not of this earth, only the original, though. Oh, I see. What's the mill? That's adorable. Previous topic. Prescott's in the Illuminati. Next stop, Haiti Earthquake Relief Fundraiser.
What? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
Hmm. Too funny. I didn't even want to read that. I was trying to read and I was just like, ah.
Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
What is with this bear?
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear.
That bear is kind of cool.
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? That really was Rachel Amber.
That's not what I was trying to do.
And she saved my life. How was last night even real? I'd like to think my humor has improved with age.
Why can't you be more positive? Too funny. Let's improve it, shall we?
Better living through chemistry.
Unbelievable. I can't with her. She's just too adorbs. Yeah.
I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually.
I still think that, that hand is pretty cool. Okay. What are we doing? I have a feeling once I change my clothes, we go straight downstairs. So let's browse some more.
How do I want to express my teenage angst today?
Because we can. Some clothes going. Oh, I could pick the shirt. That'd have been awesome, but not really. Okay, fine. That'd have been kind of cool if you could have changed the shirts all the time. Cute. It'll do. Or maybe it won't, though. Can I change the shirt? We did. I want to wear the firewalk shirt. Come on. Excuse me. Alright, fine. We'll allow it. It'll do. Won't let me change it to anything else. Rude. Okay.
Yeah, I really should get going.
Not yet.
I bet Long Mac Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago. I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
Nice. I tried skateboarding once. Wasn't very good.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
She does not respect authority.
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
She had the chance to make a CD that was called Pirate Power, and not a pirated song was on it. Wasted opportunity. But that's okay.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
Alright, let's go see what Joyce looks like. Is a serious Mr. Sharky.
Fun fact, shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died.
Not tearing that down, that's a badass freaking poster. Alright, let's go.
Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
We were ready to go.
I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
Fun.
Okay.
Boy.
Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to. I should call my phone.
Excuse me. I hate this freaking cough. It's awful.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Sad face.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. Ugh, I drank way too much last night. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Ah, messages, yay. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Wait, let's go all the way back. Will you be joining us for supper? No thanks, will you be coming home at some point tonight? Clay, will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences. Oh, goody. Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Aww. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Okay, for those who don't know, lo siento means I'm sorry. Cool. What you up to? Not much. Got ish to do later. Oh, okay, you finished the chem homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. I already know everything. Well then, Chloe. Well then, dang. Let's see. Wow, she has text messages saved from the last year. She's like myself. So, from November 2nd, 09. So sorry, I've been bad about emailing. Texting is better for me anyway. He's like, yo, it's Max. How it's going? How's it going? You there? And then she doesn't get back to her until the 13th. God, sorry again. I've been really busy. Love Seattle more in a bit. And it's just cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future. And she's like, hey, hippie, back to... It's Thanksgiving now. And she's like, I'm so sorry. Maybe we should just set up a time to call. I mean, your phone is with you all the time. There's no reason you shouldn't be able to text someone. No worries. I'll check my dance card. It's 7 p.m. in Arcadia Bay. What is it? 2019 in Seattle? She's like, I know, right? Maybe this weekend? Sure, anytime. Let me know. Queen of Crickets. What's the latest? Max. And she hasn't responded to her since November of last year. Well, the previous year. Jeez, man. And I bet you these are just all wonderful cash deals, drug deals between these two. Your ish is here. Heck yeah. But tapped out, sorry. Your loss. You can hold it for me for a day. Can I? It's your favorite customer. Are you? Frankie Holden? You still owe. You're gonna have me whacked. Terrible. Yes, please joke about that over text. You deal drugs on this phone. Come on. Anyway, it's 420. I'll meet you up if you have the cash. Ugh, rain check.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Gosh.
Yeah. Okay.
Delice.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Pirate toe.
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
T. Too. Cute. Okay, said it's in her room. Alright, we're getting there. I need to get a proper angle. That's a better angle. Okay. Purse, eh? Where is it? What book is this?
I want Mom to be happy, but not like this. Not like this!
I wonder what's in the drawer. Let's be sneaky little brats, shall we?
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Oish. Where is this woman's purse at? Purse, please. No.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Damn. That's not okay.
You should take that down to Mom.
Let's do it!
Oh, Can you grab my cell phone, too?
Fine.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, you're upset.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Said every teenager ever.
Coming, Mom.
Mercy. We're about to get it talking to. Oh, goody. It begins. I don't miss that part of teenage years. Not at all. Oh.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. Haven't really felt like sitting down to eat since David started having dinner here.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Nope, gonna keep her waiting. The sass is real.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole.
Though real estate developer Sean Prescott promised that employee layoffs would be minimal when he purchased the shipyard, he announced this week that he will be ending operations effective immediately. In a move not surprising to longtime residents of the region, the Prescott Foundation also liquidated the Arcadia Bay Stevedores Association's defined pension plan. Michelle Kinsey Robertson, staff attorney for the foundation, defended the action as our right in recoupling unrecovered losses against debts owed. John Prescott could not be reached for comment.
Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
Wildfire warning has been issued for all residents of Arcadia Bay. Fines double for illegal fireworks and campfires in unauthorized areas.
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Wow. Let me be emphatic, this is not due to financial woes, says Principal Ray Wells. After a survey of the tuitions of prestige academies in a similar caliber, we are simply keeping ourselves competitive. Blackwell parents invest in their children, not their vacation homes. Wells further emphasized that in addition to merit-based tuition awards, this year won by sophomore Stella Hill and Brooke Scott, the school's program of need-based scholarships remain in place for students who maintain exceptional academic records.
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
Nice.
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist. Wait, those aren't Mom's keys.
Ugh.
And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe?
Don't get her started. This poor plant's dead.
It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so nobody's fault, really.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back? Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case.
Damn. She's not having
Mom
a good
doesn't
time.
Want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Excuse my terrible, terrible cough. But I wanted to get this out for you guys.
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Alright.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that When your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Agreed.
Joyce Price, a.k.a. Mom. She looks as beat as I feel.
Here we go.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no-thank-you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes?
Oh, boy.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse, then?
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that-
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled?
Mothers. Mother-daughter relationships.
Between your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts.
She ain't lying.
Mom.
A lot of people do that.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Oi, that's gonna be fun. That's gonna be a great conversation.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Oh boy.
I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Giving David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Oh, boy.
Feeling trapped? Right there with you. Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Ah, boy. Excuse me. Jeez.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I'd better get going. I actually have to let this jackoff drive me to school. This is my life now. Kill me.
Boy. We have a message, and I don't know how to access the message. Oh. Hey, this is Chloe. This is Steph Gingrich. Hey, I have your DVD. You can get it before school. Thanks. Let's do it.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Terrible.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
Nailed it.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
No, please. Just get it.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. Mom should date literally anyone else. Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
Damn.
What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? By toolbox, did David mean this, or did he mean himself? This used to hang in the living room. Guess it's ancient history now. Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted.
Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff?
She is terrible.
Asking for a friend.
Told you the sass with her is so real.
Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
He's never pleased.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
True.
All right.
Not happening.
What the f-
How really? You do anything is how you do everything.
Now I need a shower.
Chloe is just too, well, no pun intended, she is
hey,
too priceless.
You're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Oh,
please don't
goodness.
Want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me? Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
I wonder how many kids are going through stuff like that, like a parent that either left or divorced or, you know, unfortunately died, and then, you know, they have to endure, like, a new parent moving in, and they're not, or a new possible maternal or paternal unit moving in, and then it's just like, oh, great, now I'm dealing with somebody else, great.
Dad loved this song. What a beautiful day. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. I guess Mom left her purse back here. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off. Dad, turn it up.
Such a bad, bad memory. Poor Cloak, though. Man. Terrible, 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 terrible memories for Chloe. Jeez.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Black Hell.
Blackwell Academy again. Bwee. She said school with no books or anything, just that stage four.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
Oh boy.
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
That's a name you don't hear too often these days, Elliot. Nice name, though.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class. Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Meh. Well, at least not for now.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Hey, I'm at picnic tables with Mikey. Thanks, on my way. Yeah.
The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole.
Ugh, Victoria freaking Chase.
Ugh, Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her. Skip Matthews, Blackwell's finest. He's not so bad for a mall cop. Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
So, you spending a lot of quality time with Justin's mom?
No. But if you see Justin, tell him I can only ignore that cloud of weed smoke for so long.
Tell him yourself, Skip. Not my problem.
I'm trying to do him a favor. I thought you high risks all stuck together.
High risks?
Oh, shit. Sorry. Forget I called you that.
Huh. High risks. Guess you can learn useful things in school. So, I went to the mill last night. Cut Firewalk live.
You went to the mill? Wait, you saw Firewalk?
It was cool.
Excuse me.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What? Like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No shit. Really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Yeah, okay.
Great.
Nice opening riff. Sounds pretty good, actually. Sounds pretty nice. I like the faces they're making at each other while you listen. Not bad. Doom, doom, doom.
So, what did you think?
Not bad. It's pretty good.
That was really good, man. If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe. Thanks.
That's cool, though. Oh, it's What's-Her-Face. Forgot this teacher's name, but she's actually one of the kindest ones. Yeah, her.
Miss Grant, the least blamed teacher at Blackwell. Wish she could get over the whole push-me-to-succeed thing, though. Morning, Miss Grant.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today.
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is sad.
Chloe's wit is amazing. Stage, though. I feel like something's gonna go
down.
Need
my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere. Huh. Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage.
Anyway, we're not gonna do that. Okay. Let's do a little joggy jog.
Samantha Myers, school wallflower. She could give you a run for your money, Max.
Oh, let's speak to Justin real quick. Just real quick.
I can tell Justin's wearing his eau de gange.
Hey, price check. Gotten in any good trouble lately?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north.
Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like Meth Central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand. Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She is amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
Dude, you need to freshen like a mofo.
Are you saying I smell like weed?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Word. Well, good looking out, Price. Wanna hit?
Like, right here? Thanks.
Oh, Justin. Who's this loner? Isn't that the artsy dude?
Ah, Evan. Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What soapbox is he on today?
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans.
That's a lot.
That's a record high and completely preventable.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now? Happy to support such an important cause. Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Thanks so much for signing my petition. Smoke weed, D-bear?
Only you can prevent ganja fires.
Nailed it.
Steph and Mikey normally post up somewhere quiet in the courtyard.
Yeah, I've ignored them enough. Okay. I'm coming.
Steph Gingrich and Mikey North, Blackwell's premier indoor kids. Steph has created something of a business selling pirated DVDs to other students.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Nice.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know, I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elima, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. Crap. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Mercy.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game!
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survives.
Excuse me.
Dang.
Don't worry, Elamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods. Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next?
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
It says here I can pick locks. Can I do that?
Sure. You spend a long time trying to pick the lock, but don't accomplish anything.
The dragonkin makes an obscene gesture at what you can only assume are his genitals. Shit!
LOL.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little wizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't—
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use—
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Everybody knows that dragons are pussies. That's why they hide in caves and only come out to breathe fire on sheep and eat cows and shit.
That was a mistake. The dragonkin growls, snapping at you and showing his teeth and claws. Tall one is a fool. Dragons are gods, he says.
Damn.
You're short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
No, no, please don't do that. Still, I cannot give key. Durgaron will eat me.
I think he's close to breaking.
I show him my fist. I call this the Ripper, because it's really good for reaching down dragonkin throats and ripping out dragonkin stomachs.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Damn.
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a +10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, "Wah ha 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 ha." Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this.
I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
Oh, Chloe.
You miss. Durgaron burst out laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Holy shit! Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
1?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankle.
Jesus, you just killed him.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
If we swing for his arm, he might drop us. If we swing for his head, either way he might drop us. I don't know. Screw it.
Bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon!
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
That was kind of pretty badass, though.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
I guess we should be headed to class.
Next up, chemistry class.
Joy.
She has an interesting walk. But seriously, she has a really interesting saunter about her.
What the hell?
What have you got here, Twitch? Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Wanna take this elsewhere, guys?
The mute speaks?
Oh, please let me insult him.
Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone!
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
No. Don't do it.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop!
Can I grab it before he throws it?
Don't just stand there watching.
Look who's talking. You're doing the same thing. Screw it.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
Oh.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
You have no idea how crazy I am. Keep pushing and find out.
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
Did you just laugh?
Yeah, she did.
Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
You shut the fuck up.
Go, Samantha.
Excuse me. Oh, man.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
For real, you're welcome.
Are you alright? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Glad we talked. Me too. I know you're doing your best. Love you. Chloe, you couldn't respond that you love your mom back, too. Lame.
That pic would actually make a sweet tattoo.
I'd have to agree, though.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people.
Nice shirt, Rachel Amber.
Oh, good. You're here.
What? Hi. Good to see you too, lady. What goes on here?
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
I'm gonna say Miranda's kind of dumb.
Miranda's an idiot, because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Ooh, that can't be fun. Hi! How you doing?
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so... Why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Sure?
Yeah. Sure.
Mind you, we haven't even engaged in, like, full conversation
okay.
Or anything.
Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit, and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? I guess the Prescott donation doesn't cover this. If I'd known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest.
There pencil drought.
Sharing is
There is a pencil drought going on.
To internet or not to internet?
Always internet.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously?
Rachel Amber, playing Prospera, a newcomer to Blackwell Academy, Rachel Amber blew the doors off her audition with a heartbreaking reading of Blanche from Tennessee Williams' A Streetcar Named Desire. Other interests include athletics, debate team, boosters fundraising, local history, and nature. Rachel hopes to one day grace the stages of Broadway and the silver screen of Hollywood. Nathan Prescott, playing Caliban. A favorite son of the oldest and most influential family in Arcadia Bay, Nathan hopes this performance of The Tempest will only further the legacy of the Prescott name at Blackwell Academy. Playing Caliban has been a challenge for the sophomore, who enjoys sports, photography, and casual hangouts with his many friends. Dana Ward, playing Miranda. A sophomore, Dana has performed in two other productions at Blackwell Academy since her freshman year. Dana enjoys football, go Bigfoots, social media, and school dances. She hopes to be a member of the Vortex Club when she's a senior. Hayden Jones, playing Ferdinand. This club marks the introduction of Hayden Jones to Blackwell Academy's drama club. He auditioned on a dare, and as it turns out, actually really digs acting. A sophomore, his other interests include playing sports, herbals, and taking long walks in the woods. Now, we all know that the herbals is probably the reefer. Juliet Watson, playing Ariel. Juliet's primary interests include journalism and social activism, but she is very excited to be debuting this spring in the role of Ariel, the capricious and powerful spirit Prospera has enchanted and bound to do her magical bidding. Travis Keating, directing. Keaton, directing. A veteran of Broadway, Travis Wilbury Keaton serves the prestigious Blackwell Academy as a teacher of the dramatic arts, mentor, and friend. He hopes this humble reinterpretation of Shakespeare's masterpiece can inspire the next generation of the country's leaders to strive for greatness and never to forget his motto, Ars Gratias. Gratia Artis. I can't even print the spell. And then you got stage managers, blah, 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 okay.
This poster definitely says something. That's the nicest backpack I've seen in my life.
It's cute.
Rachel looks so happy here.
Are we supposed to be looking for the belt in her bag? Just a belt. So much stuff.
Rachel's belt.
There we go. It's rolled up quite nice.
Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. Sweet collar, Pepe. Should be life is drama.
Agreed. Life is drama.
Rachel Amber, drama star and guardian angel. I still can't believe that was her last night. Save my life. Get some ink. Definitely an improvement. Sometimes you just gotta turn up the heat.
Is there really such a pencil famine? Jeez.
Must be 100 costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show?
More than likely.
I'm gonna guess it's from Logan. Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
Yeah,
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So, did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
I no.
I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
Yes.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly. How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Where?
ditch class.
Excuse me.
You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Alright. I was supposed to go to class, though, but didn't give me an option to not. Didn't give me an option to not hang out with her, so...
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right.
Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
Adventure of your life, Chloe.
Where does this thing go?
North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Why weren't you and Kim? Everything okay? Yep. What happened with Drew? People saying you were awesome. Yeah, let's talk later. Okay.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair. Maybe one of these crates. Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean. Whoa, Nathan's dad is a Terminator? That totally checks out. I feel pretty confident there's going to be a dead body in here. There's my chair. Thing's heavier than it looks. Guess I should sit down. I see humans, but no humanity. Everybody is somebody, but no one wants to be themselves. Some preachy graffiti up in this train. Everybody lies. I like that. I was supposed to read Huck Finn in English last year. Now I'm living it. Price 1. Twain 0. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here, so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do?
Nice.
Nice Rachel we're having.
What?
I mean, weather. It's nice weather.
It sure is.
Nailed it.
So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular.
Her name is Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
I didn't mention it earlier, but you seem to have some kind of Jedi mind powers over Mr. Keaton and the theater crew.
You mean when we were talking about true love in the play? I guess you could say I'm good with people, yeah.
Just don't pull that stuff with me.
You will get on this train.
Oh, shit.
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Try again. I'm going to need more to go on than that.
Joyrides with me aren't fun?
Joyrides to where again?
Life needs a little mystery, Chloe. Let's do something fun.
There's a flirt option. What? I'm just curious what the heck the flirt option is.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far.
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
You seem more like a Cali girl to me.
Damn, Price, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast.
I've only ever lived in Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess.
Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we? Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. I love science. Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
Huh.
I used to love country music when I was a kid. Now it makes me want to throw up. Literally.
That's weird.
I'm secretly the lead guitarist of an all-girl Misfits cover band called The Misfits.
Impressive. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. I'm not sure why country music makes you throw up.
I'm a complex girl, Rachel.
I think it's probably true. Also, I kinda like the Dixie Chicks.
You and David both. No accounting for kids.
Who's David?
He's just some asshole.
Who likes the Dixie Chicks?
He's an asshole my mom's dating, I guess.
And you don't like him.
It's still so weird that she's dating someone. My dad and my mom, they were totally in love. You can tell how fucked up she is now just by how she's settling for David. He's this total hard-ass ex-military jagoff type. Like, the opposite of my dad.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. David has no respect. He acts like I'm some kind of problem to solve. Sometimes I am a problem, though.
That's a load of bullshit.
What do you mean?
You're not a problem, Chloe. You're a person. It sounds like the only problem is David. You need to hit him where it hurts.
The only thing that David loves has four wheels and a four-barrel carburetor.
Oh, God. A muscle car?
I'm probably going to steal it soon, so...
Let me know if you need an accomplice. Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Tell me how you really feel, though. Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true. So, let's talk about this lead guitarist business.
The business of show.
As much as I'd love to be a groovy to your all-girl cover band, The Misfits, I'm gonna have to call a lie on that one.
You don't think I can rock?
On the contrary, you absolutely rock. The problem is, your hand is smooth, no calluses. You don't play guitar. Pity, too. You'd look hot on stage. So, if my math is correct, you told me two truths and one lie.
What? You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket, then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. Also, you told me about that dickwad David. Now he's on my shit list, too.
Hell yeah. Mustache brain won't know what hit him.
I guess. You opened up a lot, that's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music. Want to listen?
Music is still good, as usual. Not surprised. Wonder if they're gonna release a soundtrack. Would not be surprised at that either. But, Oi. Where the heck are they headed, though?
Cool bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach. Or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later. Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks. Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here. Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump! Fuck it! Actually a pretty nice view.
Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another one? I like games.
Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
I know all the world's a stage and shit, but I'm not an actor.
Really? I see you acting like you're tough all the time in school.
Damn it.
This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we've got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
That blows.
Well, shit. That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Oh boy, I feel like a scavenger hunt's coming on.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her. This whole day is out of order, but in the best possible way.
Rachel's quarter is still trapped in there, waiting to be set free.
That was Mikey's brother, Drew. Oh, jeez. Sorry about Drew, not your fault. My brother's not always an anus. Just most of the time, forget it.
Damn, that's an old tree. Wait, does this sign say butt rot?
It totally does. That's priceless.
Huh. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Alright. Time to scavenge.
Dwight Mueller really killed it with this statue of an explorer guy. Where are all my explorer ladies at, though? Probably at home, washing laundry and spitting out kids.
Fuck you, Dwight.
Was this how historic axe murderers searched for their next victim?
Oh boy.
Stop sextanting the interns. This Blackwall guy sure liked founding stuff that was already there. Founders keepers, I guess. If Max were here, she'd probably take a black and white photograph and call it Innocence Lost, or some shit. I guess nature doesn't quite provide.
Get out of here, woodland creatures! Have some self-respect.
This trash can is in pretty high demand.
Bye, you fools!
I wonder if I could use this to get the quarter out. Wonder if I can get that yuck. Cliche much, AW and OL?
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
Oh boy.
If you're going to argue in public, at least have the decency to make it about something interesting. Whoa, that's badass. Yep, it's official. I'm learning way more ditching school than I ever do in class. Hey, spare some change?
Sorry. We might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No, I'm not... What kind of food?
This place has really gone downhill.
Shh. She's right there.
What's worse than groveling for change? Groveling for change and failing. My hierarchy of needs goes pot, then beer, then wine. Still, wino has a classy ring to it.
What in the world can I do to get that off? Let's ponder.
Just a day in the park with Rachel Amber. You know when something kind of amazing is happening, you don't always stop to think about it right away? And then when you do think about it, you start thinking about it a lot. And the more you think about it, the crazier it seems, until pretty soon you're psyching yourself out and then everything turns to shit.
Sounds about right.
Yeah. Let's not do that today. Looks like this one might actually be working.
The lonely oak looks lonely.
Guess even trees have outcasts. I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use? That is the look of a person who is used to getting what she wants. Wonder what that feels like. I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
Nail file looks like it'll hurt.
I guess
help.
You could stab someone with a nail file. Oh, right. Sure, let's try it.
Why is Victoria Chase freaking texting me? Heck does she want? What was I trying to do? Let's see if we can do this.
Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. I wonder if I can find something sturdier to use.
Let's see if we can find... Okay, let's go back. Try to get this thing off here. Scoot a little bit. Quickly, 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 quickly. Nailed it.
Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence.
Oh, goody. Wells is on the warpath. Yay. Because his brother is a tool. That's probably why he was down. Jeez. Let's try this again.
First got power, activate.
that.
I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me.
Chloe Price, you are truly the Viewfinder Whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Nailed it.
Rachel smells like jasmine. Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
Oh my goodness, too funny.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God! You just have the best ideas. Think this guy's married to a nutritionist? He's all like, I'm not allowed to eat this stuff at home, so... I love grease! How can something that tastes so good be so wrong? Oh, dropped a fry on my suit. Now I'll have to burn it.
Good thing I have a giant squirrel costume in the car.
Terrible.
They totally stole my third grade art project. Wow, you made that?
Can't you tell?
It does have a certain give zero fucks quality that I recognize.
These two are just thought and cute together. I ship them so much.
What's going on with these two?
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
Your one son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further.
Wow. That was dark.
That's funny.
Too dark? Perfect dark.
Zero? No. Okay.
Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful. In its own way. This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Ooh, jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it. Wait, you're a prostitute? But I'm a prostitute. Now who gets paid? Rachel? Hey. Are you all right?
Do you know one of those people?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you.
I have a feeling she knows one or, if not both, of the two individuals they last saw. Oh,
they
boy.
They have a bottle of wine. Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Oh, boy.
Can we help you? Oh my god!
Okay, I'm just gonna...
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance.
Don't make a sound. Don't F it up. Too late.
Oh, thank god. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
I've seen this kind of thing before. This woman clearly has a wound that needs to be sterilized. Do you happen to have any alcohol?
I didn't see a wound.
Look closer. In the meantime, I'll search for the booze.
Hold on. There's something off about this. Are you girls putting us on?
Rachel! Run!
What the hell?
Well, that's one way to do it. And, of course, she's gonna blame him for no reason.
So... maybe your acting could use a little work, but at least you committed to the performance.
Thanks. I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Excessively sober. Jeez. What tolerance does she have? Goodness. Okay, drinking is bad enough, but drinking underage, that's also bad enough. But drinking while underage, while on an active train track, very bad idea. Don't do it. Strictly advised not to have this happen. Don't do it.
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What?
This is how they found that junkyard getaway. Oh, goodness. That's cool.
Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash. Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
I feel like she saw something she was not fond of seeing.
I've heard that actors are moody, but... wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't. Fuck!
Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that. Score. Here. If you really want to smash something, this should do the trick.
I asked you to leave me alone. Are you kidding me?
I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? A real friendship. Oh. Is that all? I mean, I don't know. Yet. But I want to find out. I thought Chloe Price doesn't need friends. I thought so too, before today. I guess it's easier to be alone if you decide it's a choice. I'm sorry for whatever I did or didn't do. Today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And I screwed it up somehow. Like I screw everything up, because I'm a fucking screw-up.
Hormones.
Please. I don't want to be alone anymore. I'm sorry, Chloe. I can't say why, and I know it isn't fair. But I can't be your friend right now. Can't or don't want to. Does it matter? I'm really sorry. Goodbye, Chloe.
Damn. Aw, Clo. No. Excuse me.
Fuck this place. Faking Hollow. Who else do I know who fits that description? Fuck off, Rachel. I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras. If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
Holy crap, is that the car? Is that the car? Damn. Jeez. That's pretty tough to not get pretty hurt in that collision. That car is ripped to shiznit. Gosh. Poor Clo-Clo. So she still couldn't even have a pretty good day. Damns. What are the chances? That you go to a junkyard and see the same vehicle.
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Oh boy. Trippy
because
flashback.
You're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on? I don't feel drunk.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
I guess I did that.
Gotta say, that was some fight. She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
What's past is prologue and shit.
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
Okay, that's a little creepy.
Rachel.
Jeez. Oh my goodness, those flashbacks are getting harder and harder. Oh, good lord. Oi. You ended up sleeping in the car, your mother's gonna kill you.
You came. I'm glad.
Are you sure about that? I got kind of a different message this afternoon.
Yeah. Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is... I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong, because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat, and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and he was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Hey, we were both kind of the queen of shitty.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and maybe you just see it as a friendship. I don't know. But I put you on the spot, and I could have handled that better. I'm sorry.
Rachel, after the day you've had, it's okay. I mean it. We have all the time in the world to figure out whatever this is.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? 2 against 1. But you wouldn't take any shit from them.
Woman, you stalking me?
I'd be dead if you hadn't thrown that bottle.
You inspired me. What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Borrow your lighter. Thank you.
Oh boy. Don't start a forest fire though, please.
Come on.
Don't kick it over. Oh, no. This is a park. Now, Evan done told you about the forest, about the wildfires, and you just legit started one. Oh, goodness. I feel like she's about to conjure up magic powers or something with this scene. Jeez! Rachel, we gotta go. The smoke alone will kill you. We gotta go. That's only gonna get worse. Guys, we gotta go. Like, seriously. Or call the fire department or something. Cause that fire. Oh, dear. We started stuff. Oh boy. Of the fire in their eyes, that's pretty good. Homewrecker! My goodness. So, I guess that's the end of episode one. I'm gonna wager. Jeez. Well, this is how, I guess, this is the origin story of Rachel Amber and, excuse me, Chloe Price. And, I guess this is how we're gonna figure out what their plan was to leave before the events of Life is Strange went down. Tis a shame, though, that, Rachel's dad's cheating on Rachel's mom. That's pretty crappy news and information. It's not good. It's pretty bad. But, you know, I was like, alright, sure, you burn the photo, that's cool. But then you kick over the trash can and, you know, it's kind of hot and you're in the forest, even though it's a park. And you're just surrounded by a lot of dry brush and whatnot. So then you pretty much set the place ablaze, and it's gonna spread. And, by kicking over the garbage can. So, yeah, you did that. And now, well, that is that. Oh, Rachel, oh boy. What I do like about their dynamic is the fact that they are able to, as teenagers, say what's on their mind and how they feel. Meanwhile, you know, as adults, we sugarcoat a lot of stuff to, you know, save other people's feelings and stuff like that. And it's really interesting how things change. When you're a kid, you're taught how to share, even though, you know, innately we're born selfish. And then you're taught how to share, and then you're taught to think about other people's feelings and be considerate of others. But then you have those people who, you know, don't teach the delicate balance, which is a lot of us anyway, that don't teach the delicate balance of, okay, sure, be mindful of others, but don't forget about yourself in the process. And it all depends on how you were raised, pretty much, because I'm a very selfless person, and finally working on being quote-unquote more selfish. Excuse me, for lack of a better word. It's just all about, everything in the world is just about balance, period. You know, having fun, working, spending time with others, having alone time, gaming, reading, anything, like, everything is just all about delicate balance. Because if you just did everything, one thing in excess, you either get tired of it, or, you know, it's harmful to you. It's like, yeah, like, for example, drinking. Sure, drinking every now and then, cool. Drinking every day in excess? No, not cool. You know. So like I said, it's just, life has a lot of ways to teach you things, and that's what I love about Life is Strange, because it makes you think about either yourself or people that you know in types of situations like these, or have similar experiences as such, and you just think about, like, wow, how would things be different if they took a different approach to tackling their problem versus the road that they're taking now? And I think the same thing sometimes about myself as well. You know, like, how could I have done this better? Or what if I had done this? And, I know we're already on the path and the journey that we're supposed to be on regardless, but it doesn't take a lot to just self-reflect and wonder, what if you've took a different route? So, I find this type of game very entertaining. And types of games like this, excuse me, to be very entertaining. People wonder why I play games like this, and it's the reason why, self-reflection and feeling something versus, like, oh, another mindless shooter. You know, shooters are great too. If you've had a crappy day, then sure, you just want to take your aggression out on fake people, in a video game. But games like this make you think about life and society and why people just don't treat each other the way they want to be treated. I mean, like, it's not that hard to do. Excuse me, really isn't that hard to do. But I don't know why society makes it seem like it's so difficult, because you have people who are selfless, and then you have people who are selfish, and they're on complete opposite extremes of that spectrum, while everyone just needs to be in the middle. It's just like, oh, sure, I could help you out. Can you help me out with this? Fine. Versus, nope, I do things just for myself and myself alone. Don't care about anybody else. Bah, F the world. Or you have the person that's, oh, I just treat others the way I want to be treated, hoping to be treated the same way, and sometimes doesn't work out that way, unfortunately. And now I'm rambling. Okay, I think you guys get the premise. You guys get the idea of what I've been trying to vocalize for the past maybe 5 minutes now. Again, sorry for all the coughs, and I'm trying to get over this cold. That's why I haven't really been streaming on top of working, pulling doubles and doubles and doubles this week. I just happen to be off this morning. I still have work tonight, and work tomorrow, so I think I have work Sunday too, so yeah, that's why. Excuse me. That's a good cough. Jeez, that was a good cough. Okay. Sorry about that. But I'm slowly getting better. And happy I didn't cough as much as I would have coughed maybe 4 days ago. But yeah. I will continue the Uncharted Lost Legacy eventually. I'm upset because I did accidentally delete my second Let's Play recording of it. I'm not going to record it again either. It's not going to happen. It was somewhat entertaining. It was just me battling a couple of bad guys, you know, and trying to unlock all of the towers that were in Uncharted Lost Legacy. But I don't think I'm gonna do a let's play. I'm probably just gonna like play a little bit, upload a little bit, because I don't feel like I'm gonna go too in depth with that game. Not sure yet. Because life changes and things happen, and it's like, yeah, I was gonna do a let's play, and then life just got in the way. Plus, I'm busy trying to finish Persona 5 and just spend some alone time with myself and just chill in my downtime, which is very few and far between these days. So bear with me. I know I promised you guys some stuff, but you know, when life happens and you get sick and you're trying to not cough like 20,000 times in the microphone uncontrollably, you just gotta take some time off and just be like, you know what? My audience will understand. You guys get it? So, I am very happy this game is. No idea when the second episode is going to be released. It could be maybe 2 months from now, if not December or January or February. We don't know. But I am looking forward to episode 2. Very much so. And see where Rachel and Chloe go next. Because I'm curious to see how this continues. Okay, so decisions that we had or could have done things. So I ran instead of attacking him. I could have attacked him, but I didn't. I was kind to Joyce, didn't want to be mean to her. I defended Nathan because he looked so damn fragile and frail. And a lot of people told Rachel that we were more than just friends. I'm like, I just kind of met her, so I don't know how we would be more than friends, even though, you know, even though the fact that I'm a lesbian, but still, I would just be like, yeah, we're more than just friends just because, you know, you kind of helped me out there. I don't know you like that. Sorry, I'm just weird. Weird like that. Okay, so 52% of us took the money, because we knew that's what Chloe would do. I didn't purchase pot from Frank. About 57% of us decided not to. That's good. I didn't read her self-help book because, ugh, God, no. I didn't know I had the option of putting William's photo on the Well. That would have been nice. I didn't know I could slip the money into her purse. If I had known, I would have done it. Yeah, Elliot seems like a cool guy. I'd go to play with him and we'll make fun of everybody. 51% of us said we liked Skip's demo, which is good. A lot of us decided to play with Steph and Mikey, that's nice, and finish it. Oh, I could have sabotaged Victoria's homework, that would have been entertaining, but I didn't do it. Yeah, falling in love is dumb sometimes. As a teenager, that's what a teenager would say. Why wouldn't you share airbreds with Rachel? Why is that not 100%? Why would you just keep that to yourself? It's two of you right there, like, boom, just, okay. Anyway, I find that funny. Don't know if any of my friends played it. Nope, none of my friends played it. Those are the world stats. Okay. Well, that was that.
Shit.
No one steals from me! I want my fucking money!
Oh boy. Well, episode 2, Brave New World, will be up as soon as I have time to put it up, and of course for after it comes out, obviously. So we'll see how that goes. But thank you guys so much for watching and listening to me cough and ramble, and hopefully you guys were entertained. Like, comment, and subscribe for more. Again, if you haven't seen my previous Life is Strange Let's Plays, episodes 1 through 5, they're available in the playlists that I have. It's well organized, simple to follow, and everything. Well, don't know when I'm going to upload again anytime soon, but I know you guys, if you want to know if I'm uploading or streaming, just underneath my channel, just click the notification bell, and it'll alert you when I am streaming or a video has been uploaded to my channel. Alright, that's enough of me talking. I've rambled enough. I don't want to cough anymore either in your ears. Again, thank you so much for watching, and Saint Mordechai out. Happy gaming, everybody.